Hi everyone, welcome back to the second part of the Learn Scriptcase from Scratch course. So we're continuing with the database side of this. We've installed our database and gotten it going. Now we need to look at some tools for administering our database, starting and stopping our database, connecting to it, etc. So we're going to look at some different tools for that. And then in the next video, we'll start building out our database structure, our tables and relationships and so forth. So my name is Nate Carpenter, as you know, and I'm the instructor leading this course. As you can see, we're in the second part here with DP setup here. So we're using Global Music Supply as a fictional company to kind of guide us through this course. And they're a music supply company, and we're building their backend database. So we set up and installed our database for that. In the next one, we'll look at the tables and everything. There's a little bit of information here for that. But for now, we need to look at some admin tools. So the solution for this, after we've installed our database and everything, we're going to use MySQL Workbench as our main tool for administering our database here. But we're also going to look at some of Scriptcase's built-in tools. We looked at that a little bit in the last video. We're going to look at it a little bit more in this one. And then we're also going to use phpMyAdmin too, which is another tool that you can install on your server for this. So that way you know all the options available to you. So let's go ahead and look at how to shut down and start up our database, and also how to administer it here. Okay, so I'm in the folder that I installed my database to, and I'm going to type in a command to start it. So mysqld.exe and //console there. So that's the command that starts it. And then as you can see, it's just sitting there and running. So now we can go ahead and run that executable that we looked at in the last video just to access our database. Go ahead and enter in our password there. And there we are in our database. And as you can see, it started up here. If we wanted to shut it down here, all we need to do is type in shutdown on the database console. Make sure I put the semicolon. And as you can see over here in the other console window, it has been shut down. And then we could just start it back up again and access it as we want. So we start it up again, put in that command again, and there we are, ready to go. So now let's look at adding some users to our database so that we can access it correctly here. So here we are in just the console with our database here. And let me go ahead and type something in here. So I'm creating a user, Nate, that's my name, at localhost, that's our current server. And then the password is going to be NatePW. So identified by is the password. And I could change that to whatever I wanted here. Go ahead and click enter. And there we go. Now that user's added. Now we need to grant permissions for that user. We're going to let that user access everything, but you could change it if you wanted. So let me copy in another command here. So we're granting all privileges on all databases and all tables there. So we could limit those privileges to update or insert, et cetera, or we can limit the tables or databases they have access to. So that way, now our user is all set up and ready to go. And now we can use that user to connect to it over here in our MySQL Workbench. So I showed you how to install this in the previous one, and you can just go ahead and run this and it'll pop up here. I've got one database connection set up here. I'm gonna add a new one to the database we just created. So we can name it whatever we want, whatever this connection name is, we can name it that. So I'm going to call it GMS inventory. The host name is going to be our 127.0.0.1. Username can be root or the Nate user you set up, and then you enter in the password that you set up for your user, and then go ahead and test the connection. And there's a character set difference where we can go ahead and click OK on that, and it was successfully made. So then we can click OK, and that connection is there for us to access. So let me go ahead and open up that connection. So it's going to open it up. And we do want to continue with this, make sure everything is good with the connection, just a character set difference there. Go ahead and wait for that to load. And now we're in our database. So as you can see, we don't have any database schema set up. We don't have any table set up or anything. So we're going to do that in the next videos. But now we're in here and we can start administering our database with this. Now that it's all set up, we can run a query here. We could create a new schema. So yeah, let's go ahead and create our GMS inventory database so that in the next video we can add some tables. So I'm going to call it GMS_inventory. You can name it whatever you want. And then go ahead down here and click apply. And yes, we want to do that. And then go through these. So that's the SQL it's going to create. Go ahead and click apply on that. Wait for that all to come around. Yes, we do. Click finish. And there is our database right there. We don't have any tables yet, but we'll look at how to do that in the next video. So as you can see, if you wanted to export this, you could go to administration down here. And then under data export, choose the database you want to export, that GMS inventory. And we want to do a complete export here. We want to dump everything and we want to save it to this folder. So it could export multiple files. We want to export it as one big file here. So I'm going to check that one here. And there's the name of that, the .sql file. And then go ahead and click start export there and continue anyway. Go ahead and wait for the export there. And there it is exported. So then you have that backed up. And if you ever want to use that backup, then you can go back here to data import again and choose your file. You're going to choose one file, not just a directory. Go ahead and select that file you just created there. And target is going to be that GMS inventory database. And we want to import everything and then start import. And it's going to go through that. And now it's imported it and restored that backup. So now we've exported and import. So that way you can manage backups and restore anything if any mistakes are made. So in the next video, we're going to look at building tables. But for now, we're going to go look at some different tools in Scriptcase for doing this.